We cheers to Lieutenant James D'Anna. Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! D'Anna, a large part of our still-growing family is assembled here today, Sunday, February 1st, 1943, over Red's house, for the express purpose of sending you an all-talking, all-singing record at our season's best. We hope you'll enjoy the following attractions at this tremendous, stupendous, colossal, all-star cast of these raving, ravenous, rebellious recruits. The favorite frivolitarians, Diane made up that word, that's why I couldn't pronounce it, of all time. The great, dynamic, you can't dim him out, D'Annas. So hang on to your hat, take care of your piece, and if you can make any sense through the din of the following clamoring and bellowing, it's purely coincidental. And oh, by the way, we have just got through eating dinner over at Joy's house, and it was a lovely delicacy, known as Campbell's Pork and Beans. And I know you must have the reports of this, and you being in the gas department, I'm sure it's right up your alley. All right, gang, and now just a moment. I must tell you that this is from the musical Ballerina. La Furiata Facciata di Berlino. Hang on your hats, boys. Here we go. Put your gas mask on. When the Fuhrer says he is the master ace, higher, higher, right in the Fuhrer's face, not to love the Fuhrer. He's the great disgrace, so be higher, right in the Fuhrer's face. Is he not the Superman?
Yes, he's the Superman!
Super Aryan Superman!
Super Duper Superman!
Cause if the world is order, we bring to the world disorder. When the Fuhrer says he is the master, be hailed! Hailed! Right in the Fuhrer's face!
Each folks!
Well, you know who that was, don't you? That was all of us. And, first of all, we'll hear from Mama. She wants to talk to you, babe, and after all, she's at the mother.
My dear son, James, I'm so glad to hear about you. You're a lieutenant now, and I hope you're going to be general pretty soon and come back home soon you can. The war be over.
Gotta go, Mama, and she means it, babe. And now, we have with us tonight a special guest, as well as a special surprise. A great seafaring man that risked his very life, braving all the dangers of the mine-infested waters of the Pacific. He's with us by the kindness of a great providence to tell us how he almost broke up a zero flotilla and that dirty Charlie, and how he ended up by serving his last stitches on his own dirty yellow belly. But wait, let him tell you in his own words. Roger Marine George Danner reporting.
Hi, babe. This is about a jet flyer that used to come over every morning and used to wake us up at 5 o'clock. Well, it was one morning that the P-38s were waiting for him and they knocked him down. Now he's serving time in a prison camp. Well, so long, babe.
Yay! Oh, boy, that was really good. And now, since there must always be a joy killer in the crowd, we'll hear from that white guy who could never be blue, Red.
Yeah, hello, Paige. I'm glad to hear you made that lieutenancy, and, well, you know, we're all pulling for you and everything, and at this time, I want to give my congratulations, and like Mom says, hope by the end of the war, you'll come back as a general. And now, you're talking about joy killers. I want to hand you over to Joy herself.
Well, I'm swell, Dave, if you know what I mean. Well, anyway, that's a hint. I guess Mary and John have told you already about them. Well, we're doing the same thing. Is it the boat or anything after you, Dave?
Well, how about that? Another James Danner in the family.
Woo-hoo!
Well, that really comes for a hand, boy. Of course, no show could ever be complete without our own great Italian John Barrymore, Sam. That Guido Pagliacci of all the bars from coast to coast. His ever-increasing waistline has been a continuous source of deep wonder from his admiring public. But his loving heart is as big as his vocabulary. And from that very spot, his voice will reach you.
Mr. Fagazzo!
Mr. Fagazzo!
Mr. Fagazzo!
Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo! Mr. Fagazzo
Tutti, su forza di vinci, anzi, a ricordare la cantina, come ha detto.
Okay, Babe, come look it over and you'll hear the rest of us.
Okay, Shade Tail, this is the other side.
Ready for you.
All kidding aside, Babe, I'm very happy to hear about your promotion. I'm really proud of you, and I hope the next time I see you, you'll become a general. Right now, Lieutenant Babe D'Anna, I salute you. Ah, boy, Sam. Yeah, do you know what the Lone Ranger said to Tonto when Tonto helped him out? Grazie, Tonto. And now, we're supposed to hear from Private Robert E. Curtis. He's supposed to report to you, but he seems to be dead in the corner over there. And so, we'll hear from our domestic domineering Ma Perkins, Diane. What's cooking, Ma?
Rabbit, but don't get in my hair. Honestly, babe, with the ration of coffee and sugar, butter and eggs, and especially of meat, we housewives find it rather difficult to stretch the bull, as we'd like to. The other day, for instance, I went to the butcher, and after beefing with him for over a half a day, I discovered he was giving me a bum steer. So I got mad and left, because I couldn't take any more of his ribbing. But I certainly found out that time does not pay. So now I must go on a diet, and I ain't a hoofin'. But I'm afraid to go down those hungry-looking streets. Some people might think this is a lot of tripe, but I'm really taking my life in my hands. They all point at me and say, my, look at that beautiful, contented cow. See what I mean? Well, I'm not trying to be horny, but time's a-wasting, and Ferdinand's a-waiting.
And as Lulu Bell goes tottering down the tulip to meet her lover, Ferdinand, I suppose you're wondering what's become of John with all this shortage of food. Well, the truth is, he hasn't lost an ounce. In fact, he's looking bigger and better every day. And incidentally, so does his wife. Well, here they are to tell you all about it themselves. Tension!
Hello, babe. Listen, babe, it makes me feel so swell to know that you're getting right along up in that Army life. And I know how all those rookies are, and I know all about a lot of that gas and all those regulations you have to go through. And I like those bars you got on there. Of course, pretty soon they'll get silver and get a couple of gold leaves and then silver leaves. And so... I won't waste much time talking much more. I'll tell you a lot better when I see you. So, Mary will tell you a few words herself.
Hello, babe. You better hurry up and come home or you won't be able to keep track of your family tree. The branches are sure spreading.
Well, there they were. Well, Giacomino, minus the Adiprano, Mom is going to sing a favorite song of yours. Take it away,
Giacomino, in Adiprano. Va volando su e giù, col volante sempre in mano, non lo vuol mollare più, tanto amabile signore, forza in aria tutti lì, e io che non devo andare, mi ripeto signor così, viene su. Anche tu con me, mi farò vedere le stelle, dalle sue
it was emptied by Russian thousands. We'll all see you later, huh?
Giacomi, noi in aeroplano, va volando su e giù, col volante sempre in mano, non lo vuol mollare più. Tanta amabile signore, forza in aria tutti lì, e io che non devo andare, mi ripeto, signor, così. Viene su